Hi, welcome back to Movie Review Mom. Today, the movie I'm reviewing is Angel Has Fallen. This movie is rated R. It's 2 hours and 1 minute, and the Movie Review Mom grade I gave it is a C. Wah, wah. In a quick nutshell, if you love playing shooting video games like I do, you'll probably like this movie because it feels like a video game. There's lots of shooting. If you love this Fallen franchise like I do, you might be a little bit disappointed. I know I was. First, some quick tips for parents. The very first word of the movie is an F-bomb, and there are many, many more that follow, as well as some other profanity. There is a very high body count. You see a lot of dead bodies with blood, and there's lots of destruction and lots of brutal fighting and violence interspersed with some dialogue. Like I said, it feels like one of the video games that guys love to play where they're running around and shooting people and shooting things. That's kind of the plot of the movie, interspersed with some dialogue. The positive themes are friendship, loyalty, and patriotism. And some of the other things that I really liked are, first of all, Gerard Butler. He has been in all three of these movies, obviously, and he gives it his all. He tries really hard. He's aging, and it kind of shows. But that's also part of the storyline, is that he's aging and he feels it. And then another one that is back in this sequel of sorts is Morgan Freeman. He was the vice president before. Now he's the president. And who doesn't love Morgan Freeman as the president? He was also the president in the movie Deep Impact, which I loved. I thought that was a really fun movie. And he admits that he actually loves playing the president. He also admits that he came back for this third movie in the series for the money of it. He says the money is much higher in sequels, and he just thought it would be really fun to play the president. And so there's that. But anyway, I also liked Piper Parabo, or Parabo, I'm not sure how to pronounce her name. She actually replaced Radha Mitchell, who is Gerard Butler's wife in the movie. And I thought she was very likable, very believable. And I didn't recognize Jada Pinkett Smith at first. I kept thinking, she looks really familiar. And then I was like, oh, wait a minute, I know who that is. So the only two that are returning characters are Gerard Butler and Morgan Freeman. If you like this almost nonstop violent action, you'll be entertained. But if you're hoping for a unique plot with character development, move on. Some things that I didn't like are, first, the very first scene looks like a video game, and I jotted that down. And then I realized the whole movie looks like a video game. One thing that drove me nuts is there's a lot of pounding drum music. I don't know that you could call it that, but just pounding drums during all of the action scenes. And because most of the movie is action scenes, there's just a lot of pounding drums. And I was like, okay, we get it. It's intense, you know, and it just drove me nuts. So I didn't really like that. Some of the special effects look good, but some of them look totally fake. And that's not unusual for this franchise, to be honest, is sometimes they nail it and sometimes it just looks like they didn't have quite the budget to get there. Nick Nolte actually is a new character, and I won't tell you who he plays. Some people are just so thrilled with his character and think that he added just some fun elements to the story, which he does, but he kind of plays the same character in every movie lately. Not that he does it badly, because he doesn't. And in fact, in this movie, he plays a Vietnam vet. And he admitted in an interview that he never actually got to serve in Vietnam because of a felony charge against him, but that he really admires and respects the soldiers, and he felt like it was an honor to be able to play this Vietnam vet. The Fugitive does this plot so much better. That is a great movie. And I kept comparing that story with what they're trying to do in this story. There's not very much humor. There's some weird camera angles. Of course, it's extremely predictable. And besides the weird camera angles, it has shaky cam effects, which I can't stand because it makes me dizzy. And I get it, you're running around. I get it, there's action, but I like to be able to just get it. I'd like to see it. And then the whole colluding with Russia, make America great again. The movie tries to be really timely and relevant and make it seem that it's, you know, in the Trump administration, but it just kind of comes across as, I don't know, leftist or just contrived. And so not as great as it could have been. So as a franchise fan that I am, I was just a little bit disappointed. The first one was by far the best. And that's pretty much true for most franchises, right? Let's see. I want to leave you with one interesting line. And this is a line by Nick Nolte. And it kind of becomes a theme of the movie. He says, sometimes it's better to know when to quit instead of lying to yourself and hurting the ones you love. All right. So you'll have to watch the movie to know what he's talking about. Anyway. Oh, where's my pillow? Gotta have the pillow, right? All right, so be sure and subscribe and ring that little bell or click on it, and that way you'll be notified every time I have a new video movie review up. And then if you want to look at more details on my movie reviews, go to my website, moviereviewmom.com, and tell all your friends while I'm trying to build this channel. I sure appreciate your support. I hope you have fun at the movies, and I, more than anything, hope that my reviews are helpful as you decide which movies are the best for your families, which ones will help you save time and money by not seeing versus which ones are worth definitely seeing at the theater. You might, wait till this one goes on to DVD or streaming until you see it. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it if you do see it, and I'll see you at the movies. Bye for now.